What's up, guys? It's me, the Dom Fanatic, in the place of Sizz Awesome here. Welcome to the second week battle of the Battle Union. Unfortunately, Sizz is unable to perform any of his managerial duties over the next few weeks, and I'm hoping I'm able to upload this video to his channel, so I'm not yet as of aware, I don't even know if that was English or not, whether this will be on my own channel or his channel. I'd like to upload them to his channel. I think it's only fair that everything goes there. Keep him active while he's away as well, so I don't leave the subscribers in the dark, because I don't think he's had even the chance to make an update video. He just put one tweet and he's gone. So I'm hoping I can put some Sizz channel. Anyway, this week, talk about being thrown in deep end. I got asked yesterday morning. I drafted a team yesterday, got home from work, genned, and here I am, waiting to battle Xenon. The guy who I looked up to so much when I was a new YouTuber and learning like how to play Pokemon. It's an honor, but a scary honor. I'm so emotional about this because Sizz is obviously such a good friend of mine. He lost his week one match, so the pressure is on for me to play really well here. And I haven't played a Pokemon, I haven't had a Pokemon battle since my last week 11 battle, so 2 weeks ago, for the PPL. I haven't even had a chance to test with this team. I'm going in blind. All I know is Xenon has got a Meloetta, because we have had genning issues galore. He had a Meloetta genning issue, and I had a issue because apparently the nickname Hentai is not acceptable for a Megalopunny. So my Pokemon work, I've tested them out. It's all about whether Meloetta works for Xenon or not. I really hope it does, because otherwise it means he has to go change his team again. I'm hoping this means he hasn't bought Keldeo, but there is no reason why he would have bought Keldeo. Alright, so this is promising. We didn't get this far last time. Okay, so here's the team. Amoongus. He doesn't have Keldeo. That makes me so happy. Meloetta. Electros. That thing is going to worry me. Piloswine. Oh, yes, he doesn't have his Defogger, which means I can hazard stack to my heart's content. Gastrodon. Amoongus and Dragalge. So we have both bought fat as hell teams, but I am prepared for the AV Meluetta, because I do have my mixed attacking Hydreigon. I'll quickly go over the team, but I won't go over it too much. I have myself a Roserade, Vaporeon, Hydreigon, Registeel, Zapdos and Lopunny, and I think I'm going to lead off with Lopunny because obviously I get the free Mega and the Fake Out. And if he wants to lead off with Piloswine, Piloswine is not going to want to stay in. I don't want him to get Rocks Up because neither of us have bought a Spinner or Defogger. So it's going to be interesting. He'll have bought Electros because of Landorus and Meloetta Assault Vest because of Landorus, which I haven't even bought. So I'm hoping he's prepared, or unprepared for the team I have, I should say. So Xenon, good luck, have fun, mate. I should get my Wrath. There is Electros, and here is Seduction. So I'm going to go straight up for the Mega Evolution. I can scout out, see if he's Assault Vest and or Rocky Helmet. Plus, it's free damage. Obviously, I don't really want to stay on this thing. It has Drain Punch. He could Thunder Wave. He could try and play for the burn. He might even Volt Switch. I'm intrigued to see what he will have. Right, that's the train line. That is not Pokemon Calcs. Right, here is my Calcs. Megalopunny. He's taking his time already. Fake Out will do... Right, he stays in, which is fine. Fake Out's going to do to 25%. If this is standard Assault Vest, and Return has a chance to KO. Oh, it's a crit. Return definitely has a chance to KO now. Return, 61 to 73%. This is physically bulky, because it would have done 25 to 29% without a crit, and to me that looks like 30% with a crit. So I want to say he's got some physical bulk on this thing. Question is, what do I want to switch in? I'm going to go into Zapdos. Hopefully, I'm expecting him to potentially be physical. I'm hoping he is, because I'm physically defense. In comes the Thunderbird, and Thunderbirds are go. I'm going to pressure, see what he goes for. Super Fang. Jabai have Roost. So I'm going to click Toxic. He hasn't got Scizor, so I can Toxic pretty much anything. Or do I Roost? Do I click Roost? No, I'm going to click Roost. Here, he might go for the knockoff. This looks like it might be a defensive one, like his last match. I did actually watch his last match, but I cannot remember what the set was. So I Roost. What's he going to go for here? He might go for knockoff. So I'm not scarfed. I've revealed that Toxic. There's the Toxic. Okay. I think this thing kind of comes a bit slightly more irrelevant due to Keldeo not being here. So I'm going to click Toxic here. And then I'm just going to get the hell out. Volt switch the hell out. This thing's got to be Assault Vest because he's not Rocky Helmet and he has not recovered any HP. So I expect he'll have Oh no, he can't be Assault Vest. He just used Toxic. Why is he? Expert Belt? Maybe? So I'll get my own Toxic off here. Which is fine. Super Fang. So, I am going to Roost. Or am I? See, I can recover and he can't. That's the thing. But I don't want Super Fang really to hurt too much. He hasn't got Rocks up yet. He's not Assault Vest. What is he? I'm going to Volt Switch. He might expect me to go for... Ah, oh, he stays in. Okay. I'm going to go into my... Registeel. No, not Registeel because I can't recover from Super Fang. Although, no, he has got Dragalge. He has got Dragalge. So, I am going to go into Ice Gem. And start setting up the spikes. Now, if he has Flamethrower, I'll be really annoyed. Because, actually, he hasn't revealed whether he's special or not at all yet. But if I can get a layer of spikes up, this will be glorious. This thing is only here, or is here for Gastrodon, mainly. But knowing Xenon, I don't think this will have a fire move. I'm thinking I'll have bought Drain Punch, expecting a specially defensive Registeel. Plus, this thing's losing lots of health to Toxic. But Hazard Removal is not here, so I'm happy. See what he goes for. Can't go for Toxic. I reckon he'll probably switch based on how long it's taken him to choose. Yeah, he switches. Okay, so three spikes. That's cool. I'm happy with my spikes. Psycho better. Okay, so he might have expected... I don't know what he's expecting there. To me, honestly, this seems like a free chance to set up my spikes. I have got the Hidden Power Fire and Technician, so I'm going to go for another Spike, see what happens here. The lack of Hazard Removal is brilliant, and his Levitate Mon is already ruined by Toxic. These Spikes can come so handy. What's he going to go for? I'm intrigued. Will he have Hidden Power of some sort? He does. What's it going to be? That didn't do much. Okay, that's fine. So I'm expecting that's probably Hidden Power Ice. What is Zapdos achieving this battle? I need this thing to scare out, Gastrodon. So, honestly, Zapdos is the most expendable thing to me. If he's going to give Hidden Power Ice, that's fine. I might even be able to live one and a Toxic, fire off a Hidden Power Fire. Oh, wow. Okay. So, what is that? That is Hidden Power Fire. Okay, so this gives me a free chance to go for a Roost, actually, and preserve my Zapdos a bit more. Because he cannot... He can't put me to sleep because I'm poisoned. So he's Hidden Power Fire. He could be hidden... No, he's not Hidden Power Flying because I'd have resisted. So I need to note this down. So HP Fire. Amoongus. What do you go for? Oh, Venoshock. Whoa! Hold on. That was Venoshock, wasn't it? Yes, okay. I'm just going to go straight up for a Heat Wave and die this turn. Because if he gets Rocks up, Zapdos is dead. So maybe this is offensive. I should take note of the moves. That was Venoshock. So, Electros was Toxic. Super Fang. That's all I've seen so far. He might expect me to go into Registeel here. So he might go for Sleep Powder or something. But I'm going to die to Toxic, so... Heat Wave hits. That's fine. I have no special attack and investment. So this isn't going to do him too much. Venoshock. Okay, so I could have gone into Registeel there. It's HP Fire for Registeel, of course. Okay. Who do I go into? You've got to be specially bulky, right? I guess we'll find out if I go into this thing and fake out. Right, let's go. There's no reason for me not to click fake out. Spike's damage is going to start racking up. Amoongus. Are you defensive? Let's just say you're max defense here. With Bold. Level 50. Fake out's going to do 20% if you're max defense. If you are not max defense, this will do 23-28%. Now, I do have the Fire Punch. But Lopunny kind of screws him over. He must have a Choice Scarfer somewhere. He's really thinking about it. Fire Punch returned us more than Fire Punch, anyway. Fire Punch was for Scizor. Obviously, he didn't bring it. So if I get a Fake Out off, it's guaranteed. I mean, it didn't... It must be Assault Vest, because he withdraws. Okay. I reckon that Meloetta might be Scarfed, actually. Okay, so he's sacking this off, basically. Don't want to show him I have Return yet. Actually, this is a bad play. I shouldn't have stayed in. I should have switched. Although he would have probably clicked Super Fang. Because now I have to switch out. So, Zapdos is dead. I've got no kills. Lupin got a kill. Yeah, there's a Meloetta. So this Meloetta is Scarfed. And I am not prepared. So the Psychic. Is he going to Psychic? I'll go into Registeel because I am Chopperberry in case he wants to go for Focus Blast. I'm fighting weak. Nice and ribbon. Trick Room! That's interesting. Right, don't let it through you. Do not let it through. Do I get my Stealth Rocks up? Or do I click Earthquake? Or do I click Toxic? What will he... So he has a Moongoot. So what does he have left? Electros is dead. He has Piloswine, Gastrodon, Moongoot, Dragalge, Meloetta left. Would he switch into Dragalge here? Is that a favourable matchup? Probably not. So I'm going to click Toxic. Okay, well, interesting. Interesting turn. Now he might, I'm going to go for Toxic again. If he wants to switch out and waste a turn of his Trick Room, that's fine. Thankfully, because he missed that Focus Blast, he doesn't know I'm Chopperberry. Which is like a godsend. I'm guessing this Meloetta is bulky. Oh my god, he missed another Focus Blast. I'm so sorry, Xenon, but this Hax is insane. Alright, do I get my rocks up? I think rocks might be helpful. What's he got? Dragalge, Amoongus, Gastrodon, Piloswine, Meloetta. So I wonder if that's an offensive Amoongus. Let's click Stealth Rock. Let's get that up. You've done a glorious job of wasting these turns. Right, he hit it. There's the Chopperberry. That is my one thing for Dragalge gone. But Dragalge is going to take a hell of... Oh my god, that done absolutely nothing. That did absolutely nothing, Registeel. You absolute monster. Right, so he hasn't got that many turns left. And I am going to outspeed, so I'm going to go for Seismic Toss. Thinking about it, this thing does get Heal Bell. But Willy, it's got to be offensive. Focus Blast, Trick Room. That was half the damage what I received, so I'll die to two more Focus Blasts. But honestly, now switching in and out with... he's going to take 50 damage confirmed from Seismic Toss, and Stealth Rocks and Spikes is going to ruin him on switches. Completely ruin him. So I'm in a really, really strong position right now. Unfortunately, it was probably due... To them Focus Blast misses, but it's Pokemon. I know he had such an unfortunate first week run of hacks. My team is just fat. It's just super fat. Meloetta is also a huge, huge threat to... Actually, hang on. Now I have the hazards up, he withdraws. Okay, that's fine. Is he going to go into Dragalge here? No, he goes into Amoongus. Oh, Regenerator, of course. Spikes and rocks. Seismic Toss. Now, am I going to outspeed him? Because if so, I'll live a hit from him. Unless he goes for Synthesis, of course. But he might be forced to switch again to get the Regenerator. Otherwise, I will just come in and kill him with a Return. Because Return is guaranteed kill on max defense, max HP, Amoongus at this point. Or is it? No, it's not. Jesus, Return only does 47.5. It's actually, yeah. If I can get a Seismic Toss off, he'll die if he kills me. So he might be forced to switch again. But obviously he can't keep switching in and out because of the spikes and Stealth Rocks. I don't think I need to get greedy now and get a third layer of spikes up. I just need to keep Roserade for Gastrodon. And I can't let him get another Trick Room up, basically. Although I can stall out the Trick Room with Vaporeon. With Wish and with... Protect. I know I'm a horrible person, but I also have Roar in case he has any setup mon, so he's really thinking. He might just click Hidden Power Fire, which I'm expecting him to have, but it won't do much. He switches that again, so I'm just going to keep going for Seismic Toss. Piloswine comes in. Now, is he going to click Earthquake, or is he going to put his own rocks up? Either way, I think Lopunny would be a good switch. Because Lopunny resists. Hang on, let me check this. Piloswine. Blank set. 252. Adamant. Earthquake. Level 50. Jesus, no, that's way too much for me to switch in. Okay. What are you going to do? Are you going to Earthquake? Wait, I can go straight into this thing. Yep, there's the Earthquake. I could have gone into, That has got to be an offensive Piloswine. That done way too much. I'm just going to Roar. Do I Roar? Yeah, I'm going to Roar, because he's going to switch into a Moongus, I think. So Piloswine obviously has Earthquake, but I think that was a given, so hang on. Trick Room, Focus Blast. Pylo has EQ. Unfortunately, I should have run Toxic on this. Yeah, he switches. Okay, so Roar. Whatever switch he wants, Gastrodon, that's fine. Could have pulled the double into Roserade. I will Roar you out. Don't go into Moongus. Piloswine, perfect. Spikes and Stealth Rock taken down to red. So he can't switch out anymore, which is lovely. So this turn I'm going to go for the Wit. He might go for Stealth Rocks. Do I want to just kill him? I'm just going to kill him. I don't care if I give him a free switch. I don't want rocks up. He withdraws. Is he going to go into Gastrodon? He is, isn't he? He does. Now he's going to get all his health back. Damn it, I should have roared again. Although that was silly, actually. I don't agree with that play at all. Because I don't agree with that. Piloswine's now dead on switching. And Storm Drain. Just Roar again then. This thing can't really touch me unless he runs Toxic. He might actually go for Recover here. He might actually go for Recover. Toxic. And he hits, which is annoying. But his team is getting so weak now. Don't go into Pylo. Oh, yeah. He goes into Piloswine. Damn it, I didn't want him to do that. Oh, I didn't want Piloswine to come in. Because that now gives him a free switch. So, Vaporeon got a kill. And, What is it? I can't even think what it's called. Oh, I just killed Piloswine. So you got one death and you got no kills. And what got your kill on? Are you going to recover? Yes. You have to recover. There is no way you cannot recover here. If you Ice Beam, fair play. But that is like a dead Gastrodon on the next switch. There's the recover. Perfect. So I expect he'll probably want to go straight into his, he'll want to go straight into a Moongus. What's he got left? I'm going to cross out the ones that are dead because it's easy to look at. Meloetta, Gastrodon, Amoongus, Dragalge. He might even go to Dragalge, actually. That would be a good switch. I'm going to click Hidden Power. He switches. Does he go out into his Amoongus? Yes, he does. The predictions... Big matches require big plays. I'm afraid. And I am making them. Now, do I spikes? What? He will kill me with another one of his hidden powers. So this would be a free switch in to Dragalge, but I can't afford to... Who have I got to die to Dragalge? I guess Vaporeon. Oh, I have Registeel. I have Registeel still. That's fine. Right, let's hidden power again. Right, yes, okay. So no other predictions there. That's fine. Amoongus, dead. So, Roserade gets one kill. Amoongus gets no kills. What got his one kill? I just said this, didn't I? What got his one kill? On Zapdos. I went, what toxic'd me? It was Electros, wasn't it? So, I don't know, I think Electros gets a kill. Okay, so here's Meloetta taking all sorts of damage. Horrible, horrible damage. I'm going straight into Vaporeon. At this point, I have more pokes where I can keep fake outing on his Dragalge and stuff. So there's the Trick Room. So how slow is Vaporeon? What has he got? Gastrodon. Amoongus is dead. I need to cross that out. Dragalge. Do I stay in? This thing gets Thunderbolt, doesn't it? I'm gonna wish. I think, yeah. Oh, right. I outspeed. I'm slower than it. Apparently, I'm slower than it. Thunderbolt. There it is. That does, like, nothing. So he might expect me to protect here. Could also switch out into Hydrite. No, Trick Room, Trick Room. Trick Room is up. Trick Room is up. So let's go for the Protect. He could pull the switch. I should have clicked Roar. He's going to switch into Dragalge. It's like the one free switch he has. And if it's like specs or something, Dragalge's going to not appreciate the hazards, because obviously he won't have recovery. Come on, Xenon. Stay in him, Thunderbolt. He withdraws. I should have clicked Roar. Should have clicked Roar. Gastrodon, okay. What's this Gastrodon going to do? That's what I want to know. So there's my Protect. I reckon he might Ice Beam. Expecting a switch. So I'm going to click... Let's click Wish again. The more he switches in and out, the better. I think Meloetta is now at the health where I can bring in Lopunny and kill it anyway. It's not Scarfed. He hasn't got any Scarfers, which means Lopunny gets outspeeds everything. And Oh, I have Hydreigon still. So as long as Earth Power, right? He does go for Earth Power. That's cool. Now, can I live another Earth Power? I didn't see how much that done. Can I live another Earth Power? If I live above 70, I'm confident I can live an Earth Power without a crit. Right, I can't live another Earth Power. At all. What do I go into? What do I do? What do I do here? He might expect to protect, so I'm going to Roar. He might go for Recover. Yes, he does go for Recover. Okay, I read that play. Now I'm gonna let Vaporeon go down. He does not have a switch for, although I can see Hydreigon missing Draco Meteor, to be honest. Trick Room's still up. Trick Room is still up, so I'm gonna protect this next turn. I don't care if I'm gonna die to Toxic eventually or not. Oh no, it's gone, it's gone. Okay, so I'm gonna fire off a Scald now. I could wish. Actually, I'm gonna wish, because whatever I bring in, we'll get health back. Whatever I bring in, we'll get health back. Right, outspeed, there's the wish. Vaporeon. Focus Blast, okay, I might live this, but I'm gonna die to Toxic anyway. That was a crit, Jesus. Adapt, because obviously there's no adaptability. I'm not switching out. So is he Specs? He could be Specs or Assault Vest. And I honestly don't know. Right, so how much does a return do to you? Let's go Dragouge. You Warbreaker. Level 50. Return to 66 to 78%. So I'm going to click Fake Out. That's if he's not defensive anyway. I just can't let him get another Trick Room up, but I don't think he can with the range of health Meloetta's at. Should have clicked return. I was tempted. Alright, we'll see how much this does. That could have been a misplay and a half. He's gonna go for the Scalds. Yeah, that's physically defensive Gastrodon if I've ever seen it. With Rocky Helmet, there you go. What? Oh, wish! I was like, why have I just got my health back? Have I just hacked the game? Gonna go into Registeel. Toxic this thing. Right, level 50. Right, return does 41 to 49%. If I had have clicked return that turn, I would have won. So I now know it's not a switch in, which is great. There's the recover. So I've got a nice free switch into this thing. Now, is he going to switch into Dragalge? I can live. Can I live a Focus Blast? I don't think I can. I will. Click. See, the thing is, he's got two Pokemon immune to Toxic, because one's really Toxic, and the other one is a Poison type, so it will. That's going to be Specs. Actually, yeah, if he wants to switch out, that's fine. I'm going to go for the Toxic. If he stays in here, that's fine by me. He might just go for Earth Power. Because if he wants to kill Registeel off with Dragalge, I can then click Return and I do win. Especially if I poison this Gastrodon. God, this has been one of the best games I've been involved in ages. Just don't do anything silly now, Jack. That's all I need to say. It's not going to have sub, but I have Seismic Toss, which won't break it, because it has over 200 HP, actually. Why would it have sub? He withdraws, so actually his Toxic isn't going to matter. Right, there's the Meloetta for the Trick Room. Did I click Seismic Toss? Or did I click Toxic? I clicked Toxic. If I had clicked Seismic Toss, I would have won! The choke again! Although I can stall out the Trick Room, actually. Relatively well here, I think. So let's click Seismic Toss. Ooh, I had speed! I had speed? Oh yeah, Trick Room. Is this gonna be enough? Oh no, he lived! No! flashbacks to me versus Fred right here. I can live a Choice Specs Focus Blast from this health. Unless it's a crit. I would have liked Meloetta to have lived that turn. Because it wastes another thing of Trick Room. Gastrodon and a half health Dragalge left. Right, I should be able to live a Focus Blast. There's the Spikes and Stealth Rocks damage. Earthquake should kill. There's the Focus Blast, and it hits. I should live. Registeel, please pull through. Pull through, my man. Yes, we ate it. We ate that up. We ate it. That's got to be the game. That has got to be the game. That's a crit Earthquake. Doesn't matter. Does not matter. I can see out the Trick Room. Oh. I don't want to get emoted. Is that a what? Is that Shiny Gastrodon? Is that what that's saying? Tell you what, this Hazard Sack idea worked a goddamn treat. Let's go for Toxic. There's the Earth Power. Toxic will be a lot more beneficial over the long run. Please hit Toxic. Yeah, not that it matters because I have got Rogues of the Raid in the background. Oh. We've done it. We have done it. Ladies and gentlemen, we have done it. Just gonna wish him GG at this point, I think. No, I can't. I can't get ahead of myself. I've typed it. Ready. There's the Ice Beam. There's no reason for me. I may actually survive this. Yeah, I do. Well, Infill Freeze. Okay. I died to the Rocky Helmet. And now, ladies and gentlemen, all Somerset Scizor fans, the moment you have all been waiting for. The All Somerset first win of the season. And it goes to you, my man. It goes to you, Sis. I don't know what's happened in your life. What? He fucking sped crept me, the little shit. That, well, I mean, he had to click Ice Beam, otherwise he would, I mean, yeah. Okay. Oh, Trick Room was still up. That was me getting complacent. Don't do that, kids. Do not do that. All right, let me click return. Actually, I'm just going to click fake out, because fake out wins, because toxic. Just in case of any genning errors. That was so silly. I could have had the 3-0. That's why you shouldn't get ahead of yourself in a league-based format, guys. That was, I hate to say it, or probably my only misplay of the match, I think. I didn't care about Rocky Helmet, but fake out toxic kills you. And, ladies and gentlemen, that is the game. I'm so glad I toxic that thing, because if I had not... then it could have been different. But good game, Alex. Not Alex. I've forgotten. I was putting Xenon because I always get the name wrong. But yeah, good game. Good game. I thoroughly enjoyed that. Sorry, I'm just typing. But anyway, thank you for that match, Xenon. I thoroughly enjoyed that. Guys, if you enjoyed this, please make sure you leave a thumbs up. Obviously, this is all for Sis. It doesn't feel right that it happened, but... but, unfortunately, Sis can't be here to do it. I mean, it was good. It was good. Sorry, I'm trying to read and type and speak and move my desk around at the same time. So, yeah, enough rambling, guys. Make sure you go check out the Battle Union below. Yeah, Xenon's just giving me the nice. I'll have to give him the nice too for that. Because it was a really good battle. Thanks, Xenon, for the battle. I'll leave a link to his channel below. I'll leave a link to Scissor's channel below. I will leave links to everything and anything that's important. So, thanks for watching, guys. I will see you next time.